Okay, this is Angie of AngiesKidney.com at the Living Green Ribbon event. And here with me is transplant recipient William Sharpe, who had kidney and pancreas. When did you have your transplant?
April the 9th, 2006.
And were there any complications with it?
Well, I was in the hospital for 2 months, so they had a few problems, but once I got out, I was clear sailing. And since I've been out, I've been feeling great. A big key to, I think, recuperating is, and staying healthy, is definitely getting into a program, exercising some type. I do a treadmill every day for an hour in the morning, and then eating properly, having a good balanced meal, and everything seems to be working great. My blood work seems to be fine every time I go to London, so I'm happy. I feel as healthy as I've been in the last 20 years, so that's a good sign. And so I've been feeling great.
So when you were diagnosed, what were you diagnosed with, if you don't mind saying?
Well, first I was diagnosed, I had definitely the kidney problem, because due to my diabetes, I've been a diabetic for 42 years, and I was taking 4 needles a day at the time. And then when I went to London to speak to the surgeon, he mentioned possibly having a pancreas transplant at the same time. And I said, geez, that sounds great. You know, it'd eliminate me taking needles for forever. And I said, yeah, I'm okay with that. That sounds great. So I had the kidney and pancreas. And because of that, I no longer take needles. And after 42 years, it's quite a relief. And my sugars every morning, I test it. They're around 4.7 to 5.86. They're never over 7.
Oh, that's
so
excellent.
That's excellent. Yeah, that's what I mean.
Your sugars are lower than mine right now.
Yeah, so I'm happy as can be. I couldn't, and for me, I don't want to ruin my kidney or my pancreas by, I don't drink alcohol anymore. If I do, it's occasional beer with my friends, but when I say occasional, it's like once every 2 or 3 months, you know, so you eliminate that, and I've never smoked, so I feel like I'm on the right track for a lengthy retirement, which is nice. I'm enjoying it, being retired, and I feel great, and I love supporting the Kidney Foundation and anything that I could do to help them, which I donate my time, volunteer at the kidney unit, so it's been very satisfaction for me, you know, and I enjoyed coming today, watching the kids being involved in this, and I think that's what they have to do, is get the young kids involved and let them know about it and aware of it, so that as they get older, they could they know what it's all about, rather than trying to teach somebody. It's hard, even for me, before I had my kidney transplant, it's hard to say, oh, well, do you want to donate your kidney or your lungs or anything? You know, once you die, obviously you can't do anything like that, so you got to make that choice beforehand. So with the young kids learning this, they might talk to their parents, say, yeah, if something happens to me, I'd be more than willing to donate your part of your body. So that's good, any of your organs.
Yeah, that's very important, because lot of people
yeah.
are so misinformed,
they
and there's really not a lot of awareness.
Yeah, it's so helpful having the young children learn about this too. So I think it's great, and I'm a happy camper.
Is there any last things you would like to say in word of spreading awareness around about kidney disease and organ donation?
Well, you know, I know the driver's license thing is important, and it's even, I think they've improved that process, because I just had my driver's license renewed, and I filled in the form. I don't know if my kidneys or anything could be donated, probably not, but you know, for the average person that doesn't have health problems, I think that's an important part. But the more that people see it, obviously the Kidney Foundation and everybody involved in the Kidney Foundation have to promote it themselves. They have to speak about the awareness of it for their friends. And I like how when they have the walk-a-thon, getting involved in it, getting my family involved. I know my sister donated her kidney to my one brother, who had the same problem with as I do, and he's got her kidney, so I asked her for her other one, so obviously she refuse me. Rotten sister, but
yeah.
But that's what you have to do. Is yeah, the more people know about it, I think the better it'll be for all Canadians involved.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Exactly. So this is Angie and Bill Sharpe of Windsor, Ontario, Canada, April 24th, 2008.
Step one, you say we need to talk. He walks, you say sit down, it's just talk. He smiles politely back at you, you stare politely.